former National Security Advisor to Vice President Dick Cheney, John Hanna, on all of this. John, what do you think?
Well, I think there's a degree of strategic incoherence here, Neil, on what the president is doing. If you really wanted to stop the Turkish invasion, if you really thought it was going to be contrary to U.S. interests, the time for making threats of economic sanctions or dispatching your vice president to engage in emergency diplomacy with Turkey and the Kurds was before the Turks went in, not afterwards. Once you've unleashed the dogs of war, and this war is very, very popular inside of Turkey to take down this Kurdish militia, it's very hard, it's going to be to put that back in the bottle anytime soon.
So, John, people like you and other generals and top military types had apparently told the president this is exactly how things would have gone, and the president didn't anyway. So he is obviously trying to address that by punishing, Turkey economically. But at this stage, is that going to be enough? Because by the time a lot of that economic punishment kicks in, Erdogan could be wrapped up.
Yeah, no, I think the damage is done. The strategic and humanitarian and moral damage done to U.S. interests, I think, is already past us, Neil. We're just looking now at mitigating the disaster that's unfolding, because not only is Erdogan in seizing that territory, destroying the Kurdish project inside of Syria, the Kurds, of course, have now invited back into that territory that was won in large part by U.S. blood and treasure, the Assad regime, and behind them the Russians and Iranians. We have spent 5 years destroying ISIS, only to hand it over now to our worst adversaries in that part of the world.
What I'm wondering is what to make of ISIS and whether, you know, some of the worst elements have broken out and are heading to God knows where. Europe is sort of a concern, but there are all sorts of other places.
Yeah, this is going to be jet fuel for the resurgence of ISIS, which was kind of already happening anyway, this ISIS insurgency that's been brewing in Iraq and Syria since the caliphate was defeated. But Baghdadi, the leader of ISIS, even just a few weeks ago, made it clear in audio tape that number one priority for him was releasing those, breaking out those ISIS prisoners and their families out of those jails. And I'm afraid now that the war that we have helped unleash here in northeastern Syria is going to do precisely that, create that opportunity for ISIS, for those prisoners and those fighters, including up to 2,000 foreign fighters, being spread to the winds to launch new attacks against the West.
Now, the president has been arguing that, and many agree on this front, that he has his finger on the pulse of the American people, who are tired of these wars without end and are justifying staying a little bit longer to make sure everything works out. And that is what he's looking at, that this has more popular support, even if it doesn't have a whole lot of military and Middle East analyst support. What do you make of that?
Well, he may be right about that calculation. We're just going to have to see, once all the dust settles and we see what the strategic and humanitarian impact has been on U.S. interests. I just am reminded that President Obama also wanted to end endless wars, right, and did something probably very popular at the time in 2011. When things were stable in Iraq, he got out against the best advice of his military and diplomatic aides. And within 3 years, we had the disaster of ISIS resurgence and America returning again to fight another war in the Middle East. Now we've seen in just 3 days what's happened as a result of this Turkish invasion and the strategic collapse that the U.S. position is now suffering in northeastern Syria. I don't know how the American people will evaluate that in the long run.
It's a very good point. John Hanna, thank you very, very much. Good catching up with you.
Thanks, Neil.